Hello everyone, this is Dr. Nikita here, back with the Brainstem Syndromes Made Easy with Mnemonics. So this is part 3 of the 5 videos that we have planned for Brainstem Syndromes. What are the 5 videos? Part 1 and 2 have already been uploaded, that is part 1 for the basic mnemonics. And then we have part 2, the midbrain syndromes. So these two have already been uploaded. This is the third part. Then you'll have the fourth part coming up, medullary syndromes. And today, that is 23rd of December, 5 p.m., we'll have a free live class, which is going to be Kaun Banega MD, that's a quiz, on these brainstem syndromes, just to make sure that you have understood everything and this topic has now become easy. So the homework for you is to complete watching all these 4 videos before 5 p.m. before the special class, so that you can be there on the top of the leaderboard in the quiz on the brainstem syndromes. So this is part 3, where we are going to discuss the Pontine syndromes, the Millard Gubler, Foville, Raymond syndrome, Longden syndrome, facial colliculus and all of that. So let's start with that. Now, in the first video, we have seen that from the pons, there are 4 cranial nerves, 5, 6, 7, 8. 5 is from the lateral aspect. It is the 6th cranial nerve, which comes from the medial aspect. You can see that the cranial nerves 6, 7, 8, they are at the pontomedullary junction. Pons, medulla at the junction. So 6, 7, 8 are at the lower level. So if the cranial nerve 6, 7, 8 are involved, that means the pontine lesion is at the lower level. That is first point to be remembered. If the 6th cranial nerve is going, that means it's a medial pontine syndrome, because 6th is medial. 3, 4, 6, 12 are medial. That is what we learned. So now going to the mnemonics for the pontine syndrome. So in the pons, 6th cranial nerve and 7th cranial nerve is what we have to remember in these major 3 syndromes, the Millard Gubler, Foville's and the Raymond syndrome. So Millard Gubler syndrome, what cranial nerves are affected? Just count the number of alphabets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have 7th nerve which is gone, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is the 6th cranial nerve which is gone. So Millard Gubler, 2 words, 2 cranial nerves gone. Which one? Millard is 7 letters and Gubler is 6. So the 6th and 7th nerve palsy. Remember we said in our previous videos that cranial nerve palsies would be on the same side, right? Ipsilateral palsies. Foville syndrome also has facial. Remember when we write Foville's, so it has facial and it has LE, that is the lateral eye movement, that is the horizontal gaze is gone. Why is the horizontal gaze gone here? Here because it is the abducent nerve, the 6th nerve nucleus which is gone in Foville's. And we had discussed in the first part that the 6th nerve connects with the opposite side 3rd nerve via the MLF. So the MLF is going, so basically the same side 6th nerve palsy, opposite side 3rd nerve palsy. And that is why there will be horizontal gaze palsy, lateral gaze palsy. Remember, Foville's is F and LE, that is facial and lateral eye, that is horizontal gaze palsy. Raymond, the trick to remember, Raymond is ON, that means only 1 cranial nerve goes in Raymond. Is it 6 or is it 7? It is the 6th only. So remember, Raymond is like DOR, it has alphabets DOR in it, that is your Dorelos canal ka DOR. The cranial nerve which goes through the Dorelos canal is the 6th nerve. So remember, Raymond is like Dorimon. Dorimon is like Dorelos canal. So the 6th nerve only goes as Raymond. Remember, this is different from the Raymond-Cistan syndrome. We are not going into those details. This is Raymond syndrome where only the 6th nerve is affected. Right? Now, going to the images here, this is how you will identify pons on MRI. This is MRI brain. This is the level of the pons. Where we see, this is the 7th, 8th nerve going to the inner ear, basically you can see. So this is the 7th, 8th nerve. So this is the lower level of the pons. This is the 4th ventricle. This part, what is facial colliculus? So look at this one. This is the pons. This is the basilar artery flow void, normal in front of the pons, 7th, 8th nerve. We are at the lower level. And this part is, here we have the facial colliculus. Basically, here we have the facial colliculus. Now, what is a facial colliculus? You can see that on the floor of the 4th ventricle, the 7th nerve fibers winding around the 6th nerve nucleus. Like if you see here, this is the 6th nerve nucleus. This is the 6th nerve nucleus. This is the 7th nerve. And from there, You can see the fibers of the seventh nerve going like this, winding around the abducens nucleus. So remember that this is the facial colliculus floor of the fourth ventricle, and it is the sixth nerve nucleus and the seventh nerve fibers. Okay. Similarly, here it is the other way around diagram. This is the dorsal aspect. This is the facial colliculus, the elevation. Sixth nerve coming medially, seventh nerve going laterally, winding around the sixth nerve nucleus. This is facial colliculus, right? Now, in the pons, in the ventral portion, this is where we have the pyramidal tract, right? The medial syndromes, motor, we said they'll involve the pyramidal tracts and cause contralateral hemiplegia. And then we'll have in the dorsal aspect, the sixth nerve nucleus and the seventh nerve fibers going like this. Now, just a quick review, Foville syndrome, facial and lateral gaze palsy. So you can see here that it is the sixth nerve nucleus. Now, this is where you see the facial colliculus. Sixth nerve nucleus is going and you have the seventh nerve fibers also going. So basically facial nerves, PPRF, that is the horizontal gaze car center, is gone. There is gaze paralysis, seventh palsy and contralateral hemiparesis. This is dorsal pontine tegmentum in the caudal third, sixth, seventh caudal, dorsal, that is where we have the sixth nerve nucleus. Millard Gubler syndrome, what is the difference? Sixth and seventh nerve fibers are going, not nucleus. You can see it is more anterior. Foville is involving the nucleus. This does not involve the nucleus. It is sixth and seventh nerve fibers. So ipsilateral facial nerve palsy, ipsilateral only lateral rectus palsy, not the horizontal gaze palsy, contralateral hemiplegia. Millard Gubler is more anterior. What is locked-in syndrome? Locked-in syndrome is your bilateral ventral pontine involvement. Then in that the patient is conscious. The eye movements, only the vertical movements, blinking is present. The patient is not able to speak. The patient is conscious because the reticular system is not affected. Only the blinking is present. So remember, ventral pontine bilateral, that is locked-in syndrome. What is this arrow pointing to? This is the facial colliculus, right? There will be sixth nerve nucleus, seventh nerve fibers going. So if we see a lesion here, like in this DWI MRI, we see this tiny area of restricted diffusion, fourth ventricle ke aage, that is the facial colliculus. It shows the area involved in facial colliculus syndrome. In Foville's, the anterior pyramidal tract also goes, here only the facial colliculus is going. So a review question for you, look at this image and tell me what syndrome is this. Is it Millard Gubler? Is it Foville's? Is it locked in? Is it Raymond? What syndrome do you think is the image depicting? Do let me know in the comments. So that was part 3 of the brainstem syndromes. So we'll have part 4, the medullary syndromes. And then at 5 p.m., we will have the quiz on the brainstem syndromes. Image-based, clinical scenarios, radiology, everything integrated, including the previous year questions on brainstem syndromes. So thank you so much for watching this. I'll see you in my next one. Till then, goodbye, take care, and keep studying. Keep revising and keep winning, and make sure that you have watched all the videos on the brainstem syndromes before 5 p.m. for the free live quiz. Thank you so much.